thou exalted Jesus, and be praised all the day. In the name of Jesus, our Lord.
Amen.
Amen and amen. Give Jesus a mighty applause. We welcome you all in the house of God. And those listening to us, those watching us in different media platforms, we will salute you in the name of our Lord Jesus. Thank you for tuning in. Those at the market, we will salute you and greet you. And those in your homes, wherever you are working, we greet you on the name of our Lord Jesus. Thank you for tuning to OPFM. We are going to begin right away. We are going to start where we ended tomorrow. Yesterday. Praise be to God. You remember where we stopped? Remind me where. Where we stopped yesterday. We want to begin from there. Someone should remind me.
Second Corinthians
chapter 11.
And
we want to begin from there.
A
danger of a compromised mind.
Good. The danger of a compromised mind. Amen.
Amen.
So that's what we are studying about this week. But tomorrow, I think I would share with you on how you can be right with God without a compromised mind.
Amen.
Now, I want you to go, let us go open up 2 Corinthians, chapter number 11. Paul was so much concerned about the church because he had encountered some individuals whose minds had been compromised. So he was cautioning the church not to go for the same mind, so they may be able to keep their mind as a church. Now, verse number one, let's begin from there. It says, what God you could bear with me a little in my folly, and indeed bear with me. For I am jealous over you with godly jealousy. For I have espoused you to one husband, that I may present you a chaste virgin to Christ. Now, why Paul used this sentence? Sometimes things that he spoke, people did not grasp them. They took them as something foolish. That's why I was telling them, please, can you bear with me? If you don't understand me with some other matters. But in this one, please, I want you to understand
me.
Now, Paul's aim was to present the church to Christ, a church that without blemish, as a chaste virgin, as a younger girl, as a young woman who had never met a man, a virgin. That was the desire of
Paul.
And the reason why we are sharing this kind of message is because we want to appear before Christ blameless.
We
appear before him as a virgin. Remember the Bible talks, Jesus said about the parable concerning the 10 virgins. All of them were virgins. But the Bible says 5 were foolish. And 5 were wise. And remember, this was purely the church. What does that mean? That in the church, there are two factions. One faction which is presented by the wise virgin, and the other faction which, with the other group which is presented by the foolish virgins. Now, my prayer for you, that you may be part of the group of the wise virgins. And that's why we are sharing this kind of a message. Can you say amen? Now, that's what Paul was saying. that I may present to you as a chaste virgin to Christ. And that has to be a burden for every minister. Every minister of the gospel. That should be the burden for that person. Now, verse number 3 says, for I fear lest by any means, as the serpent beguiled Eve through his subtlety, so our mind should be corrupted from the simplicity that is in Christ. Now Paul was calling exactly what had happened in the Garden of
Eden.
He was trying to direct the people exactly what happened that should not fall to them, happen to them again. As it happened to Eve, it
should
not happen to us. Like we said at the beginning, when the woman's mind was corrupted, she became completely compromised and began following the voice of
Satan
instead of following the voice of God. And that's a big problem. Once your mind is corrupted, ladies and gentlemen, you follow, you are being driven by the enemy. You get driven by Satan. But my prayer for you that you may not be part of that. You may always be driven by the Holy Spirit of God. I told you we are coming in a generation. We are coming in a time where you don't need even to hear from the pastor. Where you don't need to hear from an elder. Where you don't need to attend to somebody. Where you need the Spirit of God to speak to you. Because you may be in a fix. And you don't have anybody around you. These days, how will I call it? Smartphones.
Smartphones,
they black out immediately. Within a short time, it's gone. I remember when I was in Tanzania. My phone blacked out. I lost all the telephone numbers I had. Good enough, I had some people around me. But maybe by yourself. And you're not able to call anybody. And what you need is to hear from the Holy Spirit of God. There is something that the pastor cannot decide for you. There is a confusion in the world now. Because there are people who have been vaccinated and they have become sick after being vaccinated. They get vaccinated without the virus after the vaccination. They get sick. And there are those who did not get vaccinated. And also they get sick. Sometimes people die. But then you get somebody calling you. Pastor.
Musumba.
Now I've been compelled to be vaccinated. Because of my work. Because of my education. I have been refused to enter the class. Not until I get vaccinated. So what should I do? Now listen to me. A pastor is not a God. You will have to listen to what the Spirit of the Lord says. Because you don't want to be caught up in the midst of something. What do I mean by saying so? You may tell somebody go for vaccination. And when is he vaccinated? He already had some negative attitude towards that before. And when you tell him go and get vaccinated, and then he gets sick, he will begin now complaining against you. The Spirit of God had told me not to go for this. But when I asked my pastor told me go.
And if somebody doesn't get vaccinated, then he asks you, should I go for vaccinated? I mean for vaccination. And you tell him, don't go. And then he gets sick. He's also going to complain against you. So what you need now is to get tuned to the Holy Spirit. Is to have good relationship with God. Is to revive your life with God. So that you can hear what it is telling you. We are living in a generation where we need to hear from God. When we need to hear from the Spirit of God. Now Paul was very concerned. Because he had encountered the problem with some people. Let's get some people in the Bible here. Can you go with me in the book of Acts of Apostles? Acts of Apostles. Chapter number 19. Are you there?
What do you say?
Verse 19. We are going to see somebody here called Alexander.
Tugenda kulaba omusajja ono bamuyita Alexander.
At the beginning, Alexander was very fiery.
Mukusoka Alexander yali musajja wa muliro.
He was a good partner of Paul for the work of the kingdom.
Yakolanga nnyo ne Paulo ku lw'omulimu gwa
Kabaka. He was very zealous.
Yaina zero w'okuyaaya.
He risked his life for Christ.
Yawaayo obulamu bwe ku lwa Kristo.
But he reached somewhere.
Naye yatuuka wantu awamu.
And he got compromised.
Naye kiriranya.
And he turned against what was for. That's why I told you, and that's what we got to study from the Bible, that you know when you, I can see people are taking chairs. Where are those chairs going? Radio.
You should buy their own radio.
Okay, now, listen to me.
Can you put it in?
Once you get compromised, you get to forget all what you used to do, all what you used to have. Now in chapter 19, when you go back home, I want you to read the whole chapter in order for you to get a better clarity on what we are going to study about. But for me, I'm just going to pick up some verses because we don't have enough time. Now there is a confusion. In Ephesus. Ephesians were idolaters. They had a very big, a very big image of Diana. And they used to worship that goddess. A huge image. Now when the true gospel was preached, there was a great confusion. It was something new to them. They never knew a living God. They had never heard about Jesus. Because for them they were idolaters. Now Paul is coming with the true gospel. The true gospel of one God. The true gospel of salvation. The true gospel of eternal life with God in heaven. Now the Bible says there was a confusion in Ephesians. Let's go to begin reading verse 29. And the whole city was filled with confusion. Having caught Gaius and Aristarchus,
ekibuga kyonna ne kijjula okutabula kuno ne bafuutuka n'omwoyo gumu okutuuka mu Teyagero bwe bamala okukwata Gayo ne Alusu Taluko.
Men of Macedonia, Paul's companions in trouble, they rushed one accord into the theater.
Ab'e Makedonia abatambulanga ne Paulo.
And when Paul was having entered into unto the people, the disciples suffered him not. And certain of the chief of Asia, which were his friends, sent unto him, desiring him that he would not adventure himself into the theater. And some therefore cried one thing and some other, for the assembly was confused. And more part knew not wherefore they were come together.
So na abalala banji leo tategera nsonga ebakunganyiza.
Verse number 33.
Olwasatu.
And they drew Alexander out of the multitude.
Nebajja Alexander mu kibiina.
The Jew putting him forward.
Abayuda yanga bamusindikiriza.
And Alexander beckoned with them with the hand.
Alexander naba wenya no mukono.
And who have made his defense unto the people.
Nayagala okwenyonyola eri abantu.
But when they knew that he was a Jew,
naye bamutegeranga mu Yudaya.
All with one voice, about a space of 2 hours, bonna, cried out, Diana is Diana of the Ephesians.
Bonna ne bogera wamu neddoboozi limu okumala ngesaawa bbiri nti atemu wa Efeso ye mukulu.
And when the town clerk had appeased the people, he said, ye men of Ephesians, what man is there that knows not that the city of the Ephesians is a worshipper of the great goddess Diana and the image which fell down from the Jupiter?
Omuwandiisi we yasirisa ekibiina n'agamba abasajja ab'Efeso, muntu ki atategeeranga ekibuga eky'Efeso kye kikuuma essabo lya Atemu omukulu n'ekifaananyi ekyava eri Zewu?
Now, when you go home, you read the rest of the verses. There was a great confusion because of the true gospel that was preached there. Like I've told you, these were people who were idolaters. They believed that goddess image fell from Jupiter from up. That's what they knew. But you see, Alexander, he was a man who risked his life. Because he was there. You know, Paul was refused to enter because it was dangerous there. But Alexander did not keep quiet. He showed up himself in the midst of the multitude. Tried to defend Paul of what Paul was preaching. He was trying to calm them down. He was trying to encounter that confusion. Which means that time he was very famous, very vigilant. Which means that time he was very brave enough. He was strong in the Lord. But ladies and gentlemen, the time came when this man could not actually remember all what had happened that time. He's one of the people who abandoned Paul. He began preaching a different gospel. Ladies and gentlemen, that is happening to so many people. My prayer for you, and you may be consistent in your salvation. As the Bible says, work out your own salvation with great fear and trembling. Otherwise, if you're not careful, you can lose your salvation. Some people preach and say, once you get saved, you are saved once for all. Even if you see, you are already saved. That is the gospel from the pit of hell. But we see men here who backslid. They were one time strong men. This is a man who showed up himself. He never feared death that time. Because people told Paul, don't enter the theater. The disciples are known exactly how this how dangerous it was everybody like Paul to enter the theater. There was no way he could survive. But this man, he stood in the midst of the people, trying to be condemned, trying to tell them to come down, trying to tell them, please come down. And they never wanted to listen to anybody. But thanks be to God, God can use anybody. Until Until the leader of the city came. One of the leaders, the town clerk. And when he told them to keep quiet, they kept quiet. And then he challenged them with some words. And he said, "You people, why are you scared of the words of these people? Among you people, who doesn't know that this great goddess Diana descended from the Jupiter? Why are you scared of this word? Sometimes God settles matter beyond man's understanding. God sometimes can bring somebody whom you don't expect to rescue you. Now, Alexander, he was so zealous for God. He loved to serve God very much. He was a partner with Paul for the enhancement of the kingdom of God. By the time came, when he got corrupted, and when he got corrupted, he was being driven by the devil now. He got compromised with the world. My prayer for you, that you should not get compromised with the world. Stand consistently. Move forward as a soldier of Jesus Christ without fearing anything. My prayer for you again, you need to get tuned to God. That's the only way you can survive this generation. That's the only way you can make your mind survive from being compromised. Praise be the name of the Lord. Ladies and gentlemen, let's go to chapter number 1 of 1 Timothy.
Katugende mu baro ya Timotheo ekisoke sura emu.
Are you there?
Tuseo.
I'm not afraid to get there.
Kulinzo tukeo.
Paul is telling Timothy,
Paul agamba Timotheo,
possibly tomorrow we shall be using some of these words here. But we are following up the life of Alexander and his colleagues. Some people who were with Paul. Verse number 20. Let's begin from verse number 19. It says, holding faith and a good conscience. Are you there? Which some have put away concerning faith have made shipwreck. Verse number 20. Of whom is Hymenaeus and Alexander, whom I have delivered unto Satan, that he may learn not to blaspheme.
Mwabo yekumenayo ne Alexander benaweri setani balioke bali giriziwe obutavumanga.
The time came.
Jesera chatuka.
He got changed completely.
Omusajja ono nachukira ddala.
Shifted from his faith and his conscience was completely changed. That's why Paul was telling Timothy, hold to your faith and keep your conscience pure. That's what he was telling him. Of which some deny. Ladies and gentlemen, when you talk about these words, some people don't want even to listen to them. Because inside of them they are too materialistic. They want to have things that are tangible. Now when you talk about faith, because the Bible says faith is a substance. All things are hoped for. An evidence of things that are not seen. Now Paul was telling Timothy to hold on unto his faith. That's what he was telling him. And to keep his conscience pure, of which many deny, and they make a shipwreck. Which means there's no way you live that kind of life and you are going to succeed. That's what Paul was saying. Make sure that you keep your conscience very pure. Make sure you keep your conscience very well, that a devil will not come and tamper with it, and lose all what you have labored for. Remember, Alexander came out vigorously, trying to defend the faith in the multitude of which he was very dangerous. He risked his life. But when his mind got changed, when his mind got corrupted, when his mind got compromised, he forgot all that. Paul is saying he became blasphemous.
Yavuka omuvumi avola oba avuma.
He was blaspheming all what Paul was preaching. The gospel that was being preached by Paul, he became blasphemous. He tried to distort all what Paul was preaching. Remember, he knew him very well. They were partners for the kingdom. They lived together. I believe they ate together. So they knew each other very well. He knew all his ways. He knew how he used to deliver the message. He knew his type of preaching. Now, the Bible says he became blasphemous to him. Whatever he was preaching, Alexander had been changed completely. He was blasphemous. And remember what the Bible says. What happened to them? It is over our example. It is an example to us that we may not fall as they fell, that we may not be compromised as they were compromised. We may not be corrupted as they were corrupted. They become an example to us. So as you read the scripture, all these become an example. Ladies and gentlemen, I remember I went to Kenya. In a place called Maseno. There was a ministry where they invited ministers from Uganda. And you know, during Idi Amin's time, we don't have good ministers from outside to come and equip us with the word of God. So they were majorly dealing with the ministers of the gospel. So I had a chance to attend their lectures. I want to tell you, I was so much blessed. When they unveiled the life of Paul, I was blessed so much. Paul became a good example for the new Testament. And again, when they elaborated very well about Moses and his life with God, I won't tell you, I was edified so much. That was enough for me to carry out with the ministry regardless of what I went through. Because they talked about the life of Moses, the life of Paul. When Paul said, sometimes he lacked food to eat. Sometimes we were talking about nakedness, which means he lacked some clothes to put on. Sometimes he lacked a lot of things. Ladies and gentlemen, then when I went through what I went through, that message I had about Paul strengthened me so much. Ladies and gentlemen, the life of Moses, he was a great man in the Bible. The Bible says he was able to talk with God as man talks to man. Bible and, you know, one on one. He was a great man of the Bible. Ladies and gentlemen, but the time came when people turned against Moses. When people complained about, against Moses. You know what Moses did? One time God told him, you know Moses, what I'm going to do, I'm going to kill all these people. I'm going to kill all these people. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to get a nation out of you. I'm going to get another nation out of you. If it were you and me, they would say, yes, let them all go. I'm going to be very famous. I'm going to be a great man. Instead of Abraham, I would be the one where the nation of God emanates from. But Moses said, no, God. Don't destroy them. Remember, they had given him headache. They had troubled him so much. But the Bible says Moses was a humble man. He was the most humble man on the face of the earth. Instead of telling God to kill them, he instead interceded for them. He told God, don't destroy them. How would these other nations hear that God has told, has killed them? That God has destroyed them in the wilderness. Please God, spare them. And God said, okay, that is fine. If you are the one, you would pray for them to die. You would
concur
with God and, you know, for their killing. Now when I heard about Moses, ladies and gentlemen, that helped my life. What I heard from that is, I have attended two colleges.
Three colleges.
Ladies and gentlemen, but what I heard from Maseno helped me greatly
up to
this very moment. When they taught about the life of Paul, when they taught about the life of Moses as servants of God, that was a great thing unto me to carry out the ministry. Can you say amen? Now, here we see this Alexander, who was zealous for God, who was zealous for the kingdom of God. His mind is now being corrupted. His mind now has been compromised. Instead of talking about salvation, preaching the true gospel, now he's blaspheming whatever Paul was preaching. A stumbling block. Now verse number 20. Paul is saying, I have delivered unto Satan. Whom I have delivered unto Satan. That they may learn not to blaspheme. These
were
men who are with Paul. Now, ladies and gentlemen, those who are watching me now and those who are listening right now from wherever you are, you may be a pastor, you may be a minister somehow, you may find people like Alexander and Hymnas. They will turn against you. They will blaspheme whatever you are saying. They will backbite you. They will turn against you. But my prayer for you, don't be deterred. Move forward, because the Lord God is on your side. Paul did not give up. He said, I have nothing to do. I've given them up to the devil. Let the devil deal with them accordingly. Praise be the King of Kings. Can you say amen? Now let us go to chapter number 4. Chapter number 4 of 2 Timothy.
Timothy, we talk with Sulanya.
Chapter number 4.
Sulayakuna.
Let's go to verse 14. Are you there? It says, He was addressing, now Timothy. Which is also helping us. He's saying here, Alexander the coppersmith did me much evil. The Lord rewarded him according to his works. Of whom be thou? Of whom be thou were also?
Oyo now omwe kumanga.
Beware. For he has greatly withstood our words.
Kubanga yaziza nye vigambo vya fe.
That's what I've been sharing with you.
Chimbadenga wana namwe.
At the first he was for him.
Mukosoka yali kuludala
Paulo. And he was with him.
Ila yali wamu na ye.
He was a co-partner for the kingdom work.
Ngabakolera wamu ku Rome limu gowa kabaka.
But later on.
Naye oluvanyuma.
He turned against him.
Namuchukira.
What happened?
Chache chaliwo. Ndoza.
The mind had been corrupted. Now this does not apply to ministers alone. Possibly you may be a husband. Your wife is already corrupted. You may be a wife. Your husband is in the same manner. Corrupted. What are you going to do?
Ogenda kola chi.
These are not, it does not apply only to the ministers as we read here. Anything can happen. Especially in these last days. Anything can happen. But may the Lord help you. To keep your mind from being corrupted, from being compromised. That's what Paul is saying here. He says, Alexander the coppersmith did me much evil. The Lord rewarded him according to his works. Of whom be thou aware also? For he has greatly withstood our words. Verse number 16. At my first answer, no man stood with me. But all men forsook me. I pray God that it may not be laid to their charge.
It is so
ashamed.
To have people that you know
and you think they are on your side and you think they are there for you. But whereas their minds are completely gone away from you. That's why I have told you. The time comes. And you are there alone. And nobody is there for you. Nobody is there to help you. And you need one who is Jesus.
I beseech you.
If that time comes, don't complain against anybody.
No.
Stand.
Yimirira.
As a man. Stand.
Yimirira.
As a child of God.
Ngo mwana wa Katonda.
Don't complain against anybody.
No.
Stand by yourself alone.
Yimirira kululonga gwe.
And you know that now this has come. You should understand it also happened to Paul. Paul was very powerful. The whole world is talking about Paul, preaching about
Paul.
Very powerful. But the time came. People forsook him. Why? Their mind had been twisted by the devil. They forgot all what they agreed with Paul. He knew because he was a man like you and me. He thought they were on his side. But he's saying, all of them forsook me. All of them left me. And I stayed by myself. I pray
for you in the name of our Lord Jesus.
When
that time comes, standing strong in the Lord Jesus. You know that the one who stood with
Paul
is able to stand with you. He is able. Don't allow your mind to be twisted.
Once
the devil twists your mind, as Paul says, I fear. As the serpent beguiled Eve and his subtlety. Listen.
He feared
because he encountered such people. That is once it comes to you, stand strong in the Lord Jesus.
Yeah.
Yes.
Mm.
In this ministry, we all go through that.
I'm telling you, when people think are on your side, abandon you. Instead of speaking for you, they speak ill of you. Instead of defending you, they just give you out. But my prayer for you, that you may stand steadfast. The Bible says, Bible in chapter number 15, you know, but you see, let us
Let's repeat it.
Wanochigamba.
Say.
At my first answer, no man stood with me.
Which scripture?
Verse 16.
Verse 16.
Second Timothy, where we are reading.
Okay. Mukuoza kwange kolobelebele siwali enyamba.
But all men forsook me. I pray that God, it may not be laid to their charge.
Nsaba baleme okuchiba balirwa.
Nawe ngo mulokole osoro chisaba hiyo.
Can you pray that as a believer?
Okusaba nakuzino kuba kutya. Mulanga tusaba.
Prayers these days, how is it? Do you hear us pray?
Ababo naba kushudiko omulogenda kubocha.
Those that are against you, fire will consume them. That's the prayer today.
Naye no mushaje.
But this man
Agam
says, I pray to God, it shall not be accounted upon them. Someone whose mind was corrupted
is
thinking of wishing others of death. That one who hurts me, let him die.
Pray,
God helps you that you fight such a mind. You fight such a mind. Listen. First Corinthians.
15:58. It says, therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast, unmovable. Let us repeat this. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast, unmovable. Why did he put that? Therefore, because before this verse here, he was talking about the rapture, you know, how people are going to be having, you know, how do you call them? Celestial bodies in heaven.
Kwango runyiri runo nga teruna bakutuka we munyiri esoka ali ayogera kwa kuliwa abantu egereje bagenda kuba ne mibiri ejitavunda.
He was talking about the resurrection, the life.
Ayogera kulamu kuzukira no bulamu bwa Katonda.
He was talking of how there would be no death.
Ayogera nti wali bakufa.
Then he's telling them.
Kati chabagamba.
Therefore.
No lwecho.
My brethren.
Uganda.
Be steadfast.
Munywerenga.
Immovable.
Utasagasagana.
Always. Not one day. Not one month. Not. But always.
That's
my prayer for you.
No,
to be immovable.
Oh, utasagasagana.
To be steadfast always.
Kunywerera bulijjo.
The Bible says here.
Bible yagamba.
Abounding in the work of God.
nga mweyongeranga bulijjo mu mulimu gwa Katonda.
For as much as you know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. That is my prayer for you. Those whose minds are not twisted, they are not going to be moved. They are going to be steadfast all the time. Now, let's go to Peter, I mean to 2 Timothy. Chapter number 2.
Sura 2.
Verse 16. Steady to show thyself approved unto God.
Fuwa kuweraga ngosimi wa Katonda.
A workman that needs not to be ashamed.
Omukozi atakwati wanso.
Rightly dividing the word of the truth.
Aisa wakati ekigambo ekyamazima.
Now that's what I was telling you.
Icho chemba demba gamba.
You have to endeavor to read and learn the word of God.
Fuwanga nyo kuiga no kusoma ekigambo
cha Katonda. Paul was telling Timothy.
Icho Paul chali agamba Timotheo.
Born
again today and now Sunday.
But in the pastor, they the
they're waiting for the pastor. What the pastor will tell them. They're waiting for what the prophet will tell them.
They're
waiting for what so and so will tell them. Things are now
changing.
But here Paul says,
started to show themselves approved unto God. Soma kuluganda agamba tia 15. Started to show thyself approved unto God. A workman that needs not to be ashamed. Rightly dividing the word of the truth. But shine a prophet and vain babblings. For they will increase into more ungodliness.
What
dini? Now verse 17. And their word will eat as a canker. Of whom is Hymenaeus and Philetus. Remember we read about Hymenaeus. Verse number 18. Who concerning the truth have erred. Saying that the resurrection is past already and overthrow the faith of some. Verse number 19. Nevertheless, the foundation of God stands sure, having the seal. The Lord knows them that are His. Let everyone that names the name of Christ depart from the iniquity. I want to wind up there. You see what these men were preaching? You know how Paul said they were blasphemous? Paul was preaching about the resurrection. And for them, says the resurrection is past. Once you die, you are dead. And then verse
20. Now stand steadfast in our Lord. If you are serving, someone is blaspheming what you are preaching. It's not, you are not the first of a kind. Some people of the twisted mind, they are so troublesome. They are mixing up what you are preaching. They are feeling ill of what you are preaching. Paul says that they are like cancer. They are just backbiting. But God shall not forsake His own people. Praise be to the Lord. God will never forsake His own. Once God has called you to be a
son,
and you believe on our Jesus Christ, and you move as a child of God, however much you encounter
sons,
you will encounter them in the church, you will find them in
their home.
When someone, his mind is completely changed, and you look at them and you are amazed.
me speaking to you something as a father. You look upon what they are speaking and I looked at them and moved away shaking my head. Now listen. If it happened on men like Paul, once it happens on you, be strong in the Lord. God is ready.
We'll
stand with you and save you like he saved Paul. Don't allow your mind to change. Don't allow your mind to retire from
God.
Be strong in our Lord Jesus. The God who called you is so faithful. Retain and keep your mind. Move with our Lord Jesus. May God bless you. Thank you for listening to me. Stand on your feet.